my honey ginger tea. So that's gonna stay in there. Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Today we are going to my kitchen and decluttering, cleaning, and organizing my drinkware cabinet. I'm here in my kitchen, and to the left of the fridge is my cabinet where I keep all of my glasses and mugs and my tea stuff. To the left is a calendar. I've had that for, I think, about 2 decades. So that's the KitchenAid and the toaster oven. And until we are able to renovate our kitchen, this is what our kitchen looks like. You could see back here, I tried to paint the tile to see how it would look like, and it was a no-go. And then above the refrigerator, those doors, that cabinet, I have some cocktail glasses there. But these are the glasses that I have. I ordered a couple more. I think some had broken, but I've had these since like 2016, so 7 years. And it seems like only this year a couple of them broke. So these are the 8 full ounce. They're double wall, and Bodum is the original, but there are other brands on Amazon. I love these because when you have either hot or cold, your fingers don't get hot, or they're not burned, and they don't get cold. The drink stays pretty cool, and this drink stays pretty hot, and it doesn't sweat. So that's the main thing that I like. And then these are also Bodum, and these, oh, it doesn't, oh, there it is. It says here, these are the 15 ounce. So I have 2 kinds, 6 of these and 6 of these. All right, so this is my cabinet so far, and there's really not anything unique about it, I guess. I just try to keep a set of 12. So there's 12 glasses, 12 of the larger mugs, and 12 of the smaller mugs. And then these are just random mugs that people have given me that I've decided to keep. I've probably let go of 6 of these. That is one of my pet peeves, by the way. And I understand when people give a mug, especially like the Starbucks, because it's like a city and it's commemorative. I'm okay with a couple of them, but once I get more than that, or whatever random mugs you get for Christmas, or a stocking stuffer, or something at the office, you know, sorry, but I usually let those go, only because I just like things to be coordinated. Now, my kids, on the other hand, they love random mugs. Okay, up here is the tea set with the creamer and sugar, and then here are like random coffees and hot chocolates, and then this is my tea stand. Then all I do is get warm water and dampen my dishcloth with some dish soap. And then I just wipe it down. All right, so when you're decluttering, cleaning, organizing, and doing something like this type of maintenance where you're wiping down the shelves inside a cabinet and just making sure things aren't too cluttered in there, or just tidying it up, it's going to look like this, a little bit crazy, until you get everything back in there, or if you're donating or throwing things away. Yeah, even from this video, you can see that I need to clean the stove. Probably was used last night or this morning, hasn't been cleaned yet. Okay, and then I have my 3-step ladder in order for me to have been able to get up to that 3rd shelf there and wipe it down. All right, just by looking at this stuff, I'm pretty sure I'm not getting rid of anything. I'm just gonna look at this tea stand and see the things that, or the tea bags that I need to replenish here. So I can see that probably need some more lemon ginger. I think Irish breakfast is okay. Might need some more chamomile. This I love. It's lemon powder, so that's great for serving. That's why I have it here. And what I love about this tea stand is you could take out the individual one and put it, place them at the table where you're serving tea. And I got this specifically to save space in my cabinet. You can see everything, every tea that you have. And of course these work for the ones that are in bags, not the loose leaf tea. Okay, it even says tea stand here. I'll link it below in the description box. I think I got it on Amazon. Probably also have it at the Container Store. And so you can even pick, you could take one, you could take two, you know, and just place two of them at the table or the ones that people want, or you just take the whole tea stand, okay, with, let's say if you serve it with milk or with sugar, okay, and you just leave it there on the table. It works out perfectly. People love it all the time. Okay, then for the sugar bowl, I'm just gonna wipe it. This is a different rag from the one I used for the shelf, okay, because this is touching food. It's a nice clean new rag there. So you know, sometimes when you use the tea, it goes onto the lip here. So I just wipe that down. Okay, very simple. And then you could do the same for the milk or creamer holder. Okay, of course this is washed, but I just, since I'm already wiping everything down, might as well do it now. All right, then let's look at this container. These are wonderful bins, okay? These are from Target. It's the Room Essentials brand. Great price, very sturdy, and I like that they're very rectangular, you know, versus like they're going out like that. That helps with space. So this is where I keep, for sure, my honey ginger tea. So that's gonna stay in there. And I have sugar cubes because when I have a afternoon tea party, I always serve with sugar cubes. I just think it's more posh feeling that way. Okay, have some honey. And this is tea that someone gave me. They got from Hong Kong. Here, Trader Joe's hot chocolate tea stick, some more coffee. Oh, okay, it was given as a gift. And then this is more tea, which is really cute. So what I'll do is I'll just wash this. All right, so I washed it, now I'm gonna dry it. I did wanna point out the larger mugs like these. Okay, I actually have 8 of them, not 12. And because that's all that fits, and it's from this brand Mora Ceramics on Amazon. Love it. I switched out everything pretty much in my kitchen several months back. I mean, I've had my everyday dishware for probably, gosh, 17 years or something like that, and so I just decided to trade them out, and I absolutely love their stuff, Mora Ceramics. Okay, so got that. Just make sure I'm in the frame there. Okay, so I'm, okay, I know this is a little thing, but you see the brand there? I always make that the back because I just want it to, I just don't want to read the brand every time I open the cabinet. Okay, so that fits there. Okay, I think I'm going to throw away this coffee, honestly, because I haven't touched it, I don't know how many years, I think probably 2 years already. Okay, there, and then the coffee, I mean the honey, so that fits perfectly. All right, let's move to this side, and this is where I'm gonna just decide if I'm keeping all these mugs. How, I already know I'm not gonna let them go, because I mean this is as streamlined as I can get. This I got with like this subscription box. I already Globe In, I think, and I just love it. It's not the best as far as keeping anything warm, but I just love the look. And then this is from a friend, from a colleague, and gave this to me. I love it, so I'm keeping that. And then a friend gave this, and a friend gave this. So I'm keeping those. So you can see, and a friend gave this, and this is actually a really good mug, and he said he got it from Walmart. That's the brand, Home Trends. And you can see from here, that's all that it's going to fit. Now, I don't like to pile things on top because it will crack. I've already have one of these that were cracked because I think the way it was put into the sink, it just was not good. So be careful with that. I will eventually order another one, but they come in fours. I want to ask them if they could just send me one. Okay, so anyway, since I have like almost their whole collection. Okay, so that's that. Now, ideally, I would get rid of these two, and then these two would fit in here, and it would be nice and more streamlined. But I don't feel ready to give these. These are actually decent mugs. Okay, and then, you know, you see the Bodum. I have six of those, and then I have six of these. Okay, before I put everything away, I'm gonna wash this and put the mugs back in. Okay, one of the things I benefit from being organized is that I can entertain. So I know where everything is. If I'm having a large party for 60 people, if I'm having dinner guests for a table of six or 12, whatever it is, I just know all the stuff that I have, all the stuff that I can use, where they're at. So this is just my drinks cabinet. I have a whole shelf actually in my garage that is for my entertainment stuff, like platters and extra platters and bowls and things like that. Okay, when I say shelf, I mean like a whole shelving unit. So maybe one day I'll show that. Right now I'm not ready to. And for those of you who are like saying, well, I have a lot of drinkware, you know, this is me controlled. So one of the things I've decided is that, you know, I really do like to entertain. I really like having people over. It's fun. I love the company, the conversation, the challenge of learning something new to cook, you know, and that's one thing I'm gonna start doing next year is to, I've done this before for like 2 years, was every month I learn a new dish. So I'm not like overwhelmed when I'm trying to think of something new to cook. Okay, so those are the glasses. Okay, and these are for the larger mugs, this side. They're called latte mugs, I think, and they fit perfectly. I kind of tilt them for the handle to just add more space here. And like I said, there is one that got broken, so hopefully I can replenish that. So I just put three in the back. So it's a 3-2-3 configuration. And you can see why I have to turn the handle so that it can fit all the way to the edge. So you see that? And if there's one more, it would be perfect. The large mugs are the ones that we use for pretty much my daily Nespresso, and these are, I forgot what these are called, what type of mugs these are, because this brand, Mora Ceramics, they even have espresso mugs, which honestly, I will probably eventually get, but these are the mugs for now. And you wonder why I have so many mugs. Well, because when I have a party, although I have the disposable, compostable cups that are ready for guests, if there's like a large party, let's say 60 people or 30 people, I will use those. But if I have a dinner party for like 10 or 12 or 6, I will use mugs. So you can see that I have a set here for 12. I have enough for 12 people for everything to be, you know, like a nice table setting. Because I like to set the table. I don't always just do it buffet style. I do like to set up a nice table. And I'll be doing more of those videos coming up in the next couple months or next year, you know? Okay, so I like to put the handles the same way. It just looks more uniform. Okay, so that's why I have all these sorts of mugs. Okay, hold on. I'm missing one. It's there in the dishwasher. Okay, I hope that explains why I have so many mugs. It's just part of, you know, I don't have overflowing clothes. I share my closet with my husband, and that's all the clothes that I have. I don't have designer purses. Let's say I don't have designer shoes. But the thing that I really like to invest in or to have are things for entertaining. Like I have chafing dishes, I have fondue pots, things like that. Okay, then up here is for the tea and hot cocoa and stuff like that. So you can see, even from looking here, up in how I categorize, you know, each place is like a zone within a zone. So this whole zone is my drinks cabinet. I have my tea up there, small mugs, large mugs, glasses, extra mugs. Okay, and up here is for my everyday tea set. And I will confess that I have a couple more tea sets. And I have those because I like to throw afternoon tea parties. Okay. There you go. I hope this gave you motivation to declutter, clean, and organize your cabinet. If you want to see how I organize my son's apartment pantry, where he has no drawers in his kitchen, then click the next video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.